In this video, I'm going to show you the step-by-step tutorial on how to create a custom business email with Gmail for free. A lot of small businesses use unprofessional emails with @Gmail or Yahoo or @Outlook.com. But if you own a domain or if you get a new domain with Google domains, you can create a custom email like support@yourwebsite.com or yourname@yourwebsite.com, which looks way more professional. Hi everyone, welcome back. My name is Ali, and in this channel I'm sharing valuable tips and tricks about how to start and grow your small business. So if it is your first time, please subscribe and hit the like button. But without further ado, let's get into this step-by-step tutorial on how to create your free custom business email. All right, so the first step is to head over Google domains. There are other options like domain.com or namecheap.com, but I personally use Google domains. I have other domains with GoDaddy, but I would say Google is easier to work with because you can integrate with other apps easier. So some of you might have your domain. If it's the case, just click over here on the transfer a domain you already own. And as you can see over here, you have to enter your domain you want to transfer. As you can see over here, Google explains transfer process in 4 different steps. Prep domain at current, register, configure domain setting with us, initiate transfer with purchase, and confirm transfer via email. Just for example, I'll enter Nike.com to show you what's the next step. As you can see over here, it says your current register, which is in case the Mark Monitor Inc., and it asks for authorization code. If you click on the question icon, it says often called an authorization code, transfer code, or EPP code. So I'm not going into the details of transferring a domain. You can just click on the learn more about transferring a domain and see the step-by-step process. But let's get back into the first page, and let's say, like many others, you're interested to get your own domain. So over here, search the domain you're looking for. For just an example 12345, and click on the get it. Google gives you a lot of options like .com, .info, .net, .org, .ca, and a lot more. And if we just click on one of them, you can see over here the cost for 1 year is CAD 17 or $13. So I'm from Vancouver, Canada, so I pay $17 for my domain, which is really cheap, which is like $1.4 a month. So the next step is to just add it to your cart. So as you can see over here, the default mode of the first two options, which is the privacy protection and the auto renew, is both on. This is free and you have to make sure they're both enabled. But if you scroll down a little bit, this is the part that I want you to focus on. Now, Google asks for an extra fee for the monthly subscription for using a custom email in Google Workspace, and it has 3 different packages. It has Business Starter, Business Standard, and Business Plus. If you just change them, you can see the price changes as well. So the first one is almost $8, the second one is 15.6, and the third one is CAD 23. But what I'm going to teach you in this video is to use another way to have up to 100 custom emails for free. You can have your name @yourwebsite.com or support@yourwebsite.com and so on. So I want you to simply ignore this custom email section and click on the checkout now. So I want you to enter all of your information, your name, country, address, city, postal code, and phone, and pay just for your domain. So as you can see over here, I already purchased my domain, which is alirastegari.com, my first name and last name, and it automatically renews on December 23rd. Every year, and the privacy protection is on over here as well. So let's say I want to create a new custom email called info@alirastegari.com and connect it to my Gmail. From the menu on the left side, we are going to click on the email and scroll down a little bit until you see email forwarding section over here. As you can see, it says email forwarding allows you to set up email addresses, which are alternative addresses that are used as a substitute for an actual email address. Add up to 100 email addresses that forwards you to your existing email address. Google domain will send a verification email to each unverified recipient address. So click on add email at the bottom and add a new custom email, let's say info. And over here you have to add your existing email. So I'm just going to enter my email and click on the add. It says this email won't work unless it's verified. So I want you to just head over to your email and verify this email address. After I verify this email, if anyone sends an email to info@signaddressegory.com, I'll be able to get that email in my existing Gmail inbox. But what I want you to know is that until this point, you have done only the 50% on the process. I mean, now you're just able to receive the emails from this custom email. But if you want to send emails from this email, we need to head over the Gmail setting and I'll show you the step-by-step process. So if you're getting value from this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Right now we are in the Gmail account, and what I want you to do is to click on the right setting gear over here and click on the see all settings. Now head over to accounts and import, scroll down a little bit, and as you can see over here it says send mail as use Gmail to send from your other email addresses. You can click on learn more to get more information, but here we are going to click on another email address. So as you can see, this yellow page will appear. Now in this email section, I want you to enter the email that you just created, and the name can be the name of your company, your first name, or whatever you prefer. But over here I want you to enter your new email address. So here we're going to say info@signaddressegory.com, and I'm fine with my name over here, and make sure this one over here is checked. So click on the next step. In the next step, you have to configure your SMPT servers. It looks a little bit confusing, but don't worry, I'll tell you exactly what to do to complete this step. Over here in the SMTP server, I want you to click on this part and delete it and write Gmail instead of that. Over here in the username, you have to enter your current email address, which is the email address that you're currently using, not the new one. So add your username and your password as well, and make sure this port is on 465. And make sure you check the first one. It's really important. Make sure the SSL connection is checked. Now, a lot of you might see this error code over here. It says authentication failed. Please check your username, password, and less secure apps access for your email. Now, to solve that error, Google wants you to edit your secure accounts, which I don't recommend it because I have a safer and better solution for it. But just to let you know, the normal process, you need to head over to your Google account, which is this page, and in the security section, usually there is a less secure app access section over here, and you just need to turn it on. But the better solution is to, instead of using less secure or disabling your Gmail account two-factor authentication, create app password for the email instead of that, and use that. So as you can see here, we are in the Google account page, the security section, and I want you to scroll down a little bit. And as you can see over here in the signing into Google, there is a section called app passwords. So I just want you to click on it. It asks for your password. And over here, you can select on the mail and select your device, let's say Windows computer, and generate a one-time password. Now, this is something that you don't need to remember, and you can just take a photo with your phone, but you are just going to use it once to enter your password. So just click on the generate and head over back to the yellow page. Now, I want you to do all the process again. So make sure that over here, you remove the name, whatever it is, and replace Gmail. And make sure this port is 465. Usually the default mode is this one, but I want you to choose 465. I want you to enter your current Gmail account, and this one over here, I want you to enter your new password, the password that you just created in your Google account. Make sure this secured connection is using SSL and click on the add account. There will be just one step before you send your first email using this forwarding tool. And that's the final verification. So it says, congrats, we successfully located your other server and verified your credentials. Just one more step. A confirmation code was sent to your email. Click on the confirmation link or just simply copy the code and enter the verification code over here. Now that you have done the both forwarding and also the sending section, you can just head over here and click on the send an email. Over here, as you can see, you can change all of your email addresses. You can change if you want to send it from your name @ your website or info @ your website to any email address at the subject, at the text, and send. Congrats! You just created your first custom business email in Gmail, which you can create up to 100 free emails for your website. I hope this video made the process easier for you. Now, for all of you that are interested to know more about the Google Workspace, I'm going to explain what's Google Workspace and the top 5 benefits of using Google Workspace. Workspace lets you or your company control the data. You will be able to optimize your data using the best security protection. You can break down all of the information from different apps and leverage artificial intelligence to make your team or employees more collaborative and finish projects faster. You will be able to experience ultimate digital transformation and let your team work in new ways. The first thing is you can store and share unlimited files with Google Drive. With Team Drive, everyone who needs access already has it. And if an employee leaves the company, the Team Drive manager can quickly revoke their access to any company data. Both individual drive and Team Drive come with unlimited cloud storage in Google Workspace. Storage space is limited to 30 gigabytes in Google Workspace Basic, which is still twice what you get in the free version. The second benefit is you can integrate with CRM and other apps. By integrating Google Workspace with your CRM and other Google apps, your team can work amazing across different apps, all from inside the Google Workspace app. Employees access all of the apps with a single sign-in and they don't waste time going back and forth between different apps. Your company gets a productivity boost and you don't have to worry about the data inconsistencies and human error. The third benefit is that you can create websites with Google Sites. With Google Sites, you can create a high quality website. It's easy to design and you don't need any programming knowledge or experience. You can pull content from Google Drive, Docs, or Google Forms and just simply drag and drop them. The fourth benefit is that you can let AI to improve your productivity. Google Workspace leverages artificial intelligence to remove any friction and automate simple tasks. For example, when employees book virtual meetings in Calendar, Google Assistant automatically finds a time and adds optimized rooms for each person. The fifth benefit is that you can manage everything from just one admin console. The Google Workspace admin console lets you to manage all of the data, users, and apps from just one single dashboard, which lets you to customize the user experience, enable or disable permissions, and create rules, and so on. For instance, you can enforce security keys or block untrusted apps easily. Now, if you have any questions, please make sure you leave it in the comment section. If you have got value from this video, please make sure that you smash the like button and let the YouTube know that this video over here has value, and make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so you'll stay ahead of the competition with the latest digital marketing tips and tactics. Make sure you watch one of these videos over here. As I explained in this video, there are tons of valuable tips and tricks in these videos over here, so just click on one of them right now. There are tons of valuable resources and tools that I use to run my own fitness equipment brand, so make sure you head over the menu and click on the My Gear, and you'll see what tools, softwares, and equipment I use to run my business. As always, thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.